गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड 12 अकाउंटेंसी यूनिट 5 एडमिशन ऑफ योर पार्टनर. ओके, सो व्हाट इज एडमिशन ऑफ योर पार्टनर? मीनिंग ए पर्सन मे जॉइन एज ए न्यू पार्टनर इन एन एक्सिस्टिंग पार्टनरशिप फॉर्म. दिस इज कॉल्ड द एडमिशन ऑफ पार्टनर. ओके, सो इन दिस वीडियो वी गोइंग टू डिस्कस एंड सी द रिवैल्यूएशन ऑफ असेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज. Okay, what do you mean by revaluation of assets and liabilities? Mean when a partner is admitted into the partnership, the assets and liabilities are revealed at the current value may differ from the book value. So, determination of current values of assets and liabilities is called a revaluation of assets and liabilities. Okay, so let's see the sum number 4. I read the question. Hari and Madhavan and Kesan are partners in the sharing the profit and losses. The ratio is 5:3:2. So, as the 1st April 2017, Vanmari is admitted into the partnership form and the new profit sharing ratio decided to 4:3:2:1. So, the following adjustment are to be made. First one, increase the value of premises. Increase the value of premises. 60,000. Second one, depreciate the stock 5,000, furniture by 2,000 and the machinery by 2,500 and provide for an outstanding liability is 500. Pass the journal entries and prepare the revaluation account. Okay, see, let's see the solution now. So first adjustment, increase the value of premises by 60,000. So increase the value of asset. So increase the value of asset. Premises means asset, you know that. So asset increase, so the entry will be concern asset account data to revaluation. Concern asset account data to revaluation. So concern asset here, premises. So what is the entry now? Premises account data to revaluation. So the amount 60,000. So being increase the value of premises recorded. Understand? So next one, second one. Depreciate stock by 5,000, furniture by 2,000 and machinery by 2,500. So depreciation means loss. So loss means revaluation account data to concern asset. So revaluation account data. Revaluation account data to stock account. To furniture account to machinery account being depreciated depreciated amount recorded. It recorded. Okay, so reverse stock amount 5,000, furniture 2,000, then machinery 2,500. So total 5,000 plus 2,000 plus 2,500, 9,500. Okay, then next entry, provide an outstanding liability. So liability is increased. So liability increase means loss. So the entry will be revaluation account data to outstanding liability. Revaluation account data to outstanding liability. Revaluation account data to outstanding liability. So debit credit side. So the amount is 500. So debit side 500 and the credit side 500. Okay, So increase the value of asset means revaluation credit side. So the premises account data to revaluation 60,000. Then decrease the value of asset means loss. So revaluation account data to stock account, to furniture account, to machinery account. And third adjustment, the outstanding liability is provided. So liability is increased. So loss. So revaluation account data to outstanding liability. Next we are going to see the revaluation account ledger. So I will write the journal entry. Now we are going to work out the ledger. So first one, revaluation premises account data to revaluation. So credit side, so buy premises account, so profit, so buy premises account 60,000. Then revaluation loss debit side to stock account. Stock account 5,000 to furniture account 2,000 to machinery account 2,500. Then next, provision for outstanding liability. Provision for outstanding liability is 500. Okay, so let's see. Debit side to stock, furniture, machinery, and provision for liability. Then credit side by premises. So which side is more? Credit side is more. So 60,000 minus 5,000 plus 2,000 plus 2,500 plus 500. So 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 2, 9, 9,500 plus 500, 10,000. So debit side total is 10,000 and credit side total is 60,000. So 60,000 minus 10,000. So the answer 50,000 revaluation profit. Revaluation profit. Okay. So the profit will transfer to the old partner's capital. So the old partners are Hari and Madhavan and Kesan. Okay. So old partners, the 50,000 is transferred to the old partners. So Hari Capital, Madhavan Capital, and Kesavan Capital. So the 50,000 transfer to the ratio of 5 is to 3 is to 2. So 5 is to 3 is to 2. So total parts is 10. So for Hari, 50,000 into 5 by 10. For Madhavan, 50,000 into 3 by 10. And for Kesavan, 50,000 into 2 by 10. So the total for Hari 25,000, for Madhavan 15,000, and last Kesavan for 10,000. Okay, so the profit transfer to the only old partners. So Hari Capital is profit 50,000, ratio 5, so 5 by 10, 25,000. Then Madhavan 50,000 into 3 by 10, 15,000. For Kesavan 50,000 into 2 by 10, 10,000. So the profit, we have to write the journal entry. Fourth journal entry. Okay, so date, particulars, I love. debit, credit. So profit is 50,000. So the entry will be revaluation account data. Revaluation account data to Hari Capital to Madhavan Capital. Madhavan Capital account to Kesavan Capital account to Kesavan Capital account. So revaluation profit 50,000. So 50,000 into 5/10 for Hari, 50,000 into 3/10 for Madhavan, 50,000 into 2/10 for K7. So 25,000 for Hari, 15,000 for Madhavan and 10,000 for K7. Okay, being revaluation profit transfer to old partners capital account. Old partners capital account. Okay. Understand, students? I hope you all understand the revaluation of assets and liabilities. Thank you.